Allow yourself to start to settle on the mat. And start to bring your awareness to your body, to your breathing. So when you breathe in, imagine that you start to receive a really nice, gentle energy of relaxation, peace, comfort. And imagine that energy moving around, melting, dissolving the physical tension, the pain that we have in the shoulders, hips, knees. But also imagine that that energy goes like into your mind and your heart. Yes, softening the worries, the stress, anything that could be bothering. So again, when you breathe in, imagine receiving all that beautiful energy, imagine that energy moving. And when you breathe out, imagine that you start to release your tension, your stress to the floor, to the roots. And imagine that through the roots, you also start to receive the energy of the planet. Yeah? So all the energy that you need with the qualities that you need, imagine you receive that through the roots from the planet, plus the energy that you receive through your breathing. And remind yourself that the roots also are like a recycle centers to recharge your own energy, to cleanse your own energy. Yeah? So when you have all that in place in your mind, yeah, imagine that you set all those processes in motion. We relax. We relax the hands to the floor or to the legs, and we soften without forcing wherever is possible. And then we move the hands to one side. And then to the other side. And then coming back to the center. We put the hands behind, grounding your hips, open your chest, breathing deeply. And then relax your chin to the chest. Ah, relax. Now we bring the other leg forward and we soften. And then we move the hands to one side. And then to the other side. And then to the center, coming back. We put the hands behind, pushing into the floor. Imagine that you are pushing into the hips to activate that receiving of energy. And spread, expand, open. And relax your chin to the chest. Ah, we soften. And we will move the chest in circles. So breathe in forward, breathe out back. And then the opposite direction. And then forward and up with your chest, with the shoulders away, and then relax, like a rounding a little bit. So breathing, pushing into the hips to expand your spine, and then relax. Yeah, one more time. And in the next time that we are nice and grounded and lengthening chest open, we start to rotate with the shoulders relaxing away from your ears. Lengthen, expand. And keeping the position, we bring the head to the front and to the other side. Soft, yeah, no forcing. And then back. And relax to the center. And again, pressing, expand. We rotate to the other side. Shoulders away, lengthen. And keeping the position, we bring the head to the front and to the other side. And then back to the twist. And relax. Well done. We will expand the arms a little bit here. And we will stretch, trying not to lift in the shoulders. Again, trying to push into the hips, yeah, to feel that expansion. And when we feel nice and long, we will relax one arm and we will put the hand on the head, really gentle and sweet. And we soften. So there is no forcing, but you keep activating the solar plexus and the chest up. And then the other side, taking your time. And then relax the shoulders. Good. And we will go to all fours. We'll start to move the hips in circles. So soften. Shoulders away here. And when you go forward, try to expand your chest. And then we go to the opposite direction. And then on the center, breathing and open arching, expand. And then we round. Breathing, open, expand. And round. And then we will curl the toes, expanding open, and squeeze and round. Try to squeeze a little bit the lower belly,
close to the pubic bone, so you activate also the pelvic floor. And then we open the knees and we go back to child pose. Softening, relaxing your shoulder blades, your elbows, relaxing your head. Soften deeply, surrender. Imagine that you are giving permission more easily, tension, stress, or any pain. And then we go to one side. And then to the other side. And then to the center, we put the elbows on the floor closer to each other. Try to soften, so go more back or bring the elbows more forward to try to touch with your chest. And soften. Then relax, and we will go to all fours, and we will move the shoulder blades a little bit, softening, so really gentle and soft. And then the opposite direction. Good. And we bring one arm underneath the other arm. We expand and we soften here. Relax. And then we change and we go to the other side. Gracias. With the, then you go back and start to bring the hips back and your chest, your belly toward your thighs. Relaxing your head. Oh, move a little bit side to side. Yeah, so you feel not stuck there. Yeah. Oh. And then we can start to move the legs as well. One by one, like a walking. No forcing it. Just try to feel that you stretch the legs and you are relaxing the leg down. Good. So with the belly in, I'm trying to bring the heels down to the floor. We move forward to plank. So you keep the heels back. So you feel a nice stretch on the legs. Shoulders away, belly in. Lengthen in the back of the neck. And then hips out and back. And expand and open. Good. We do it one more time. Yes, so we go forward. Shoulders away, chest open, belly in, hips tilting forward, heels back, and then again, hips out, open, expand. And relax. We put the legs on the floor. And with the shoulders again away, bring one leg back, arching and rounding. Okay? So move your spine nice and soft. But big. So move the head as well to follow the line of your spine. So the head up when you arch and the head down when you round. And one more time. Good. And then we change. You go with the other leg. Expand it and round it. And again, expand it and round it. And one more time. Well. And we bring one leg forward. And we soften it with the leg. So, relax your shoulders, relax your hips, spread. So, let your hips fall and remember when we do this kind of movement, try to open your foot more, right? Connect more the sole of your foot. So, you have like a more grounding to relax more your hips. Lengthen your spine, chest open, shoulders away. We expand, we lengthen. Spread without tensing, but reach up without lifting the hip. Yeah, the hip really like a heavy going down to the floor and you stretch. Good. Now we will put the opposite hand on the floor. The shoulder is back. Yeah, check that the shoulder is not pointing. Up and we will rotate the neck as well, and we lift the arm wherever is comfortable. Okay, now try to keep the hips moving forward. Yes, so the hip is still, you go forward. Coming back, we will put the hands beside your foot. We move the foot a little bit more to the side. Yeah, and again with your hips forward. Now move a little bit there to work on the hip. We don't force it, okay? But let the groin open there. Good. And then coming back, we go back. We can put the hands on the floor or on the blocks. Yeah? So heel on the floor, toes up. Again, a little bit of movement so you don't feel so stiff on the position. If it's uncomfortable, you can always put one hand on the chin, okay? Or on the blocks. And then we change. We go with the other leg. So again, we go forward, relaxing. Soften. And as you fall down and forward, spread also your foot even more. And then expand. And spread, reaching up without tensing. Spread your foot. And then we put the hand on the floor. So check if, don't go back with your hip yet. Try to keep bringing the hip forward. Check that the shoulder is in. And then rotate slowly, belly in. Rotate the head and then your arm. Check, yes, very nice, very nice. Don't force the arm, just the chest, wherever it's possible. Come back with the hand. We move the foot to the side and we keep relaxing your belly, your groin there, shoulders back. And then coming back and we move the foot to the center and back slowly. Spread back. And we walk forward. And we go all the way up. Grounding your feet, expanding, shoulders away. Remember not to block the knees. And spreading. Again with softness. And then we go to the side, soften knees. And then we go to the other side. And then spread. Go. Relax, release. Soften. Well done, very nice. So we will go to the top of the mat. Breathing, expanding, open. And breathe out, relaxing. Confío on the hips, confío on the knees. Relax completely your back, your arms, your neck, your head. Just stay there for a moment just to feel your body relaxing. Let the shoulder blades also spread. So using the weight of your arms, let your shoulder blades expand. And then we put the hands on your shins. We look up, open, and we put the hands back. Shoulders away. And chest and chin, or all fours. So you can do all fours or upward facing dog. And then back to downward facing dog. Expand, open, spread. And we bring the right leg forward to warrior two, connect. Yeah. So check the front knee and the front foot and settle. Yeah. So like we do on the floor, let your hip relax and go down here. Expand, open. We put the arm on the front leg. We open hip, we lift the arm, spread. Reach with that hand really high, but without tensing, to open your spine, your chest. Then we move the arm forward toward the window, toward the sea, expanding the left side. And then pressing into the front leg, hand on the back leg. We open the front, keep relaxing the hips, the shoulder is comfortable. And keep the knee open. Yeah, yes, beautiful. Coming back, settle, rotate, back to plank. Shoulders away and chest and chin. Expanding, pressing, forward belly in or all fours. Shoulders away. And then up. Hips, belly, solar plexus, head and heels. We bring the left leg forward. Check the front knee, check the front foot, yeah? And again, relax, settle. Relax your hips. Spread open. We put the front arm, expanding open. Spread your chest nice and open, yeah? Good. So lifting the solar plexus up. Yeah. Coming up, we put the hand on the back leg. We open. I always forget on the left side, the going forward, sorry. Good. So we will go forward one more time and we bring the arm. Spreading, yeah? Lengthening, like it toward the C front, yeah? Lengthening the side from the heel to the fingers. But at the same time, try to open your chest. Yes, beautiful. Coming back, warrior two, and rotate. Back to plank. Shoulders away. So, elbows closer. If you go to the upward facing dog, then you push forward and up, belly in expanded, and then up. Open. And then we bring the legs forward toward the hands. And we go all the way up, expand. And lengthen, very nice. So we go one more time, breathing open, expand. Breathe out, relax, soften. Breathe in, lengthen open. Breathe out, plank. Shoulders away. And we go again. So all fours or upward facing dog, belly in, expanding open. We go up. Spread. Go. We bring the right leg forward. Go. Well done. Now we will rotate to warrior one. Okay, so we will move the hip forward, belly in, and lengthen. Settle. Yeah. So the back foot as much comfortable as you can. Yeah, the hips facing forward. We keep relaxing the hips. Settle down. Good. Expand your arms. Open the chest. Shoulders away. And we go. Hip. So knee, hip. And then we go like inside the leg. Belly, solar plexus, chest, head. That's also to help us open the hips, yeah? And then head, chest, belly strong. And open the arms, rotating a little bit more, yeah? Good, and again, open. Catch the hands, rotate the shoulders, and again, hip, belly, solar plexus, chest, head, and then again, up, expanding, open, and squeeze. Open back to plank. Shoulders away, chest and chin, belly in, expand, and then up. Oh, we bring the left leg forward. Here, go. Very nice. So, facing the front, yeah, and squeeze. Check that we are facing the front. Yeah, belly strong. Good. And then we open. Once you catch the hands, rotate the shoulders. Don't stay like this because if not, we are tensing more the shoulder. Yeah. And then again, so knee, hip, And we go like on the side. And then again, head, chest, belly strong, shoulders away, we open. And one more, expand. Try to catch your hands without moving the shoulder forward. And again, spread, and then up, expanding, open, go, and relax. Well done. Go. And then chest and chin. Pushing. Expanding. And then up. Go. Then we bring the legs forward toward the hands. And we go all the way up. Expanding. And length. Well done. Very nice. So we will put the blocks on the front. You can catch two blocks. At home, you can do it. Yeah, they are all clean. At home, ladies, we can use or a nearest wall or a little chair or the couch, whatever you have closer, or your desk, whatever you have closer. You don't need to be on the mat even. So we will put the blocks in front of you. We'll go to warrior three. So same position that the warrior one. So we face the front, and we will do the same opening with the arms, and we will go to the blocks to lift in the back leg, So breathe in, put the hands on the blocks or on the chair, and we lift in the leg, So the intention is that you are looking forward, the chest is open, your arms are strong wherever you have it, even on the wall, shoulders are away, chest open, your back foot is flexed. So bring the heel, very nice. And then we try to bend the front leg and come back, grounding to warrior one. Expand, Well done. Now, we will do the same, and this time you can repeat it on the block, or we try to go forward, to balance, So you decide on what. We'll do two tries, So breathe in, open. Open the foot so you have more balance and try to spread. Doesn't matter if we fall. Go. Expand. Spread. And then to come back, bend in the front leg. Go. So if you feel, and relax, if you feel that you're about to fall, go down. Don't wait until you fall. So try to recognize. It's also for the balance. So we do the last one with this leg, So, shoulders open, ground your foot, and spread. Heel and expand, far away with your hands and far away with your foot. The leg that is down is not blocked, Go. And then bending, bending, check, 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 connect. Relax. Well, very nice. We go with the leg. Good. Very nice. So we do first, if you like, with the blocks, just to get the posture, Or on the floor. So expand. So rotate. So the warrior three is from warrior one. So the hips are facing forward, So we take our time. We go to the blocks. Spread the back leg. So the knee that is down, don't block it too much, Rachel, even if you can. Don't block too much the knee. Exactly, And spread your chest up, shoulders away, Try to flex more the foot, Ross. Yes, very nice. And then bending the front leg. Go, and expand. Go, well done. So instead of feeling Rachel on the knee, try to feel it on the foot, the ground, the strong part, So we do one more time. Now we go forward or back to the, So take your time.
spread your foot, and always we have one leg that is more easy. It could be this the easy or the hardest, yeah. And try to spread, good, expand, comfy. When you feel that you are about to fall, bend, put the foot, and cha cha cha. Yeah, look in the Olympics. We do one more, yeah. Last one. Breathe in, yeah. So start like open your foot, yeah, the front foot. Boom. And we go. And chuck, 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 taking your time. Spread, expand. Don't worry if we fall. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. And then when you're about to fall, chuck, chuck, chuck. Expand. Well done. And from there, we will go all the way down to the floor. And back to plank. Shoulders away. Yeah? Go. And then chest and chin. And forward. Open. And then back. Spread. Stay a little bit on the downward facing dog. Softening. Bringing the belly and the chest over your thighs and relax your head. Yeah, check that the head, the neck is soft. Well done. And then we relax in child pose. And we soften. Well done. Relax. The arms could be forward or beneath your head or beside your body. Good, and then coming back, we will go to this position without the blocks yet, yeah? But have, if you need, we will do like a little starting of the camel position, but really gentle. Have the blocks around, maybe we need it, maybe not. So what we will do is, we will press, imagine this part at your feet now, yeah? So you press into that part, and we go up now. Hips tilting forward, yeah. So this is strong, and then you're lifting up, yeah. So we are not squeezing the lower back and falling down, we are lifting up, yeah. So nice and strong this part. We are strengthening and we are stretching at the same time, yeah. So shoulders away, we can put the hands here to relax also the shoulder. We keep lifting up. And we lift in the arms without hanging, yeah? So this is long, straight. The sensation of arching is coming from this part, yeah? And then we will relax the bum, and we go with the bum back, yeah? So you notice a difference on the movement of the hips. So we work one more time. Pressing, the hips are tilting forward. Expanding. Good. Now, if you like here, you can put or the hand on the leg, or you can use your block, whatever you prefer, depending on your height. And we spread, this shoulder is rotated back. This is up, but shoulders are soft, yeah? So you lead with your chest and the solar plexus forward and up. And then relax your bum. Go down. Good. And then again, pressing, squeeze, lengthen, and spread. Yeah? So check that you are not feeling the lower back. Spread. Shoulder away. Yeah? And then relax, release. Ah, we sit here. So here you can put, if you need the blocks, yeah, or just stay here. So we stay in hero pose, yeah? Or if it's too difficult, this position, we sit with the legs crossed, yeah? So if you like, you can put it. Cool. So we will expand, pushing into the hips. Whether you have it on the heels or on the blocks or sitting, yeah? Push with the hips, lifting solar plexus. It's always this action, yeah? That's make sure that your spine is straight so we can work in a better position, yeah? And we are strengthening. So shoulders away, expand open here. Yeah? So try to soften the shoulder, but try to open this part, yeah? Make movements there so you feel that you are free to move your ribcage, your back. And then we will round, going closer. And then again, you push into the hips to go up, shoulders are relaxed. And we will do a little bit of rolling with your elbows. Now, as you do that, you keep going. The shoulders are down. Yeah, we are not doing in this position. Yeah. Keep the arms the same position, just rotate to the other direction. Just to feel the shoulder blades movement. And then expand. We will go to the other arm. But first, feel that you can move all this part without, there is two different movements. Yeah? So we don't need to do this when we move this, yeah? Go. And then we bring the other arm. Relax your shoulders and again. Go. Soften. And then the opposite direction. Go. Well done. And then we spread, expand, open. Shoulders away. We put the hand, we put the other hand with the shoulders rotated, yeah, and expand open. You keep pushing with the hips, you keep pushing with the chest up, the shoulders are relaxed. Your elbows trying to open back, but not so forced that you feel intense or your breathing is not comfortable. Yeah? And then relax. Expand, shoulders relax. When you put the arm again, rotate it back. Yeah? Open. And then relax, release. And we will stretch your legs. And expand. Good. Well done. Good. So we will move the legs forward. Yeah. Oh, just sit, sit, sit. Yeah. Once we go to the floor, we never come back up. Don't worry. That's my philosophy. Good. So we put our leg forward. Yeah. So first we put like the warrior one and the warrior three that we practice. So facing the leg. Yeah. Okay, so comfy, you go into the hip. If you notice that you can't, that you keep your body back, bend the front leg so you can go, yeah? And then check how much you can extend the leg without falling back again, yeah? So check that, you always want to be on the hips, yeah? So we open the chest and we will try to go toward the leg, yeah? So with your belly, with your chest. The head is the last, so the head is going toward the toes, not toward the knee, yeah? Toward the knee goes like your chest. Wherever you can, doesn't matter. And then you move the arms wherever is okay. We don't force, eh? And we use a breathe out to soften toward the leg, but not forcing, not tensing, yeah? Doesn't matter how much we go, it's wherever your body can go. So it's nice here to close your eyes so you are not tempting to see where you are. You feel where you are. Soften. Now we will come back slowly. Again, recheck your hips. Yeah. And this time we will go like a between the two legs. Yeah. Okay. So we open again. And we go with the belly again. Wherever you can. Yeah. So it's like a diagonal. We are not forcing it, yeah? Yeah. Now try to keep the balance of both hips. Yeah. Yeah, good. And then come back. Well done. Very nice. We will put the hands behind. Grounding both hips. Open solar plexus, open chest. So take your time here to move in the pose so you can open more without tensing, yeah? And then check if you can open the leg a little bit more. In this position, you can lower your knee, not forcing, but try. Expand. And then relax, yeah? And then this leg will go crossing over. Now, you will turn that way, yeah? When we turn, you will do this way. We go the other way, yeah? So you catch the knee. Again, chuck, 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 chuck. And from there, we rotate toward the thigh. And we expand. Yeah, very good. So Mora and Gail to the other side. Yeah, that way. Yeah. Yes. And make the space with the belly like above the thigh to rotate a little bit more. Shoulders away. Yes. So, Ross, put the left hand behind you and try to rotate more toward the mirror. Yeah. Yeah. And open more your chest. Yes, that's the intention. And relax your shoulders. Yes, beautiful ladies. Well done. Coming back. Well done. Now, we will put the other leg. So the leg that was here, now is extending and we bend the other leg. Yeah. Good. Well done. Very nice. So again, first we connect the hips, check if you need to bend the leg, go into the hips. Yeah. And then we try to face the leg. Yeah. So with the belly, with the chest. And then you go wherever is possible. Yeah. Wherever you can go. Don't force it. Using your breathing. And then slowly coming back. And now we will direct like in the diagonal. Yeah, so like you face me. Yeah. So again, you ground your hips and try to go again with your belly, with your chest. No forcing, eh? Go slowly, feeling your hip, feeling your hamstring there. Yeah, so go really slowly to make it comfortable for your body. That's okay, that's okay, that's okay. Yeah, 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 that's normal, yeah. You are still stretching the legs, so don't worry, yeah. Keep pushing with the hips, yeah? And you try to go with your belly and the solar plexus, yeah? That will be, if you do that movement up, you still have a nice stretch on the leg, even if it's bending, yeah? And then coming back, slowly, we bring the hands behind. Open, spread, shoulders away. Yeah. So once you put the position, work it a little bit so you feel, yeah, so you feel your back and accommodate your shoulders. Ah. And then relax. Very nice. And then we put the leg that is bending, crossing. Yeah. So we all go, I know, that way, and you rose this way. Yeah. Cool. So pressing again into the hip. Doesn't matter if you don't touch, yeah? Even you can put the toes. Yeah? So hip, hip, hips. And then rotate. And expand. Yeah? Yes, beautiful. Try to relax the shoulders down. Oh, well done. Very nice. Yeah. So put the left arm on your knee. Yeah. No, you're sorry. Yeah. And keep opening the chest. Yeah. Now, Rachel, if you like, you can put the arm this time, this way. Yeah. And so you can relax the shoulder a little. Check whatever is more comfy. Yeah. And then relax and release. Well done. Beautiful. We go down to lying down on the back. Yeah. Finally. Go ahead. So we bend the legs. We will do one bridge because we already did back bends with a camel position, okay? But it's always good to do a bridge, yes. So take your time before to go to the bridge. Take your time to expand your lower back, to lengthen, to spread. And once you feel nice and comfortable there, we press into the feet and we go to a sweet bridge. No forcing, just opening the back of the neck, opening the groin, spread. Then relax, release, and we soften. We bring the knees to the belly. We roll a little bit there, side to side. And we will go to one side. And we soften, yes, opening the arms. Relax your shoulders away, soft, and release. And then we go slowly to the other side. Taking your time. And then coming back to the center. And we go to Shavasana here. So nice and comfy. Spread. Now just for a moment. Visualize again your roots, yeah, catching you there as you start to soften more and more into the mat. Imagining that connection, you reactivate the receiving of the nourishment, the nourishing energy from the planet with all the qualities that you need. Remind yourself that around you, you have a beautiful, loving, caring energy, minding you, relaxing you. And we receive another flow of energy coming from the sea here, from the seafront. So at home, imagine that I send you this energy from the sea here. And connect with that quality of the sea, the water, the cleansing action of the water, but also that movement of the water, that fluidity, yeah? That calmness. Yeah? And imagine that that quality also goes into yourself. So imagine ready there, the sole of your feet, to let in this energy. And this energy is moving toward your toes now, on the top of your feet, your ankles, your heels, and then up toward your legs, passing through your knees, passing through your thighs and your hips, your lower back, your whole spine, your middle back, your upper back. Imagine that energy flowing through your shoulders and then into your arms, to your hands, your fingers. And then imagine that energy moving into your wrists, elbows, and then again through your shoulders toward your neck, the back of the head, the crown of your head, your face, your neck, your chest, your belly, allowing your body to surrender completely to the floor and going deeply inside now and relax, relax, relax. And now slowly, really slowly, allow your awareness to get back to your body and start to bring some movements to your hands, to your feet, moving your fingers, your toes, moving your head side to side. And bringing your arms back and lengthen and stretch. And from there we go to one side, bending your knees. And to a sitting position. And give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to come to class. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me. Thank you.